Now, this is one of the best, strongest sorcerer builds in Dragon's Dogma 2. The sorcerer is one of the highest damage output vocations in the game. The sorcerer is able to one-shot certain bosses and will easily melt dragons. In this guide, I'll cover the best skills, setups, and gear upgrades to easily handle any situation. So let's check this out. Okay, so first I'm going to show you destroying this dragon. Now, the sorcerer is one of the top vocations when it comes to damage, specializing in devastating magical attacks. Not only does the sorcerer deal massive damage, but they can also apply crowd control effects on enemies. Now, the sorcerer does face long channel times for their spells, but the sorcerer has a core skill called quick spell that can make the casting time a lot faster in return for stamina. But this core skill won't affect the sorcerer's meister skills. The sorcerer also possesses a skill called galvanize, which rapidly replenishes your stamina when activated. While you can use this skill while moving, its effectiveness will be reduced. Galvanize is a strong skill that enables you to regenerate stamina easily, relieving the need for augments or gear focused on stamina, thereby freeing up slots for other enhancements. The one challenge the sorcerer faces is their defense and survivability, as they lack escape skills. Therefore, it's advisable to have a pawn that can draw aggro from enemies. Additionally, if you're hit while channeling any spells, it will be interrupted. But I'll go over everything in more details in their dedicated sections. Okay, so next for the weapon skills. Now, I tested all the sorcerer's weapon skills, and some spells just outperform others. Additionally, the sorcerer possesses two meister skills that are very powerful, but the meister skill has a very long channeling time. I'm going to go over the best weapon skills I personally use to handle any situations, but you can switch around the meister skill depending on your playstyle. So the first weapon skill I'm using is High Levin. This spell casts lightning bolt from above the enemies, allowing for continuous strikes. Now, this spell is really good to easily clear groups of trash enemies, and if you don't defeat the enemies right away, you can keep attacking with this spell, although it will drain more stamina. The next weapon skill I'm using is High Haggle. This spell creates a blizzard in a circle, dealing AoE damage that inflicts frostbites on enemies. Enemies hit with this spell become slow, and with continuous damage, they can be frozen. This spell is particularly effective against bosses, slowing them down and potentially freezing them. And this spell is especially strong against dragons, as they are vulnerable to ice damage. The next weapon skill I'm using is Augural Flare. This spell attaches a target with a magical orb that explodes after some time when attacked. You can continually strike the orb to increase its explosive potential, making this skill incredibly powerful. This spell is particularly effective against bosses, and your pawns can also capitalize on its devastating effects. And the last skill I'm using is the Sorcerer's Meister skill, Meteoron. And this spell will summon a meteor shower, dealing massive damage to targets in a wide area. Now, the Sorcerer's Meister skills have very long channeling time, and it is unaffected by the core skill quick spell, so you do want to use this spell in the back line and not being targeted by any enemies. Now, this is the ultimate boss killing spell for the sorcerer. Now, some of the meteorites from this spell can miss the enemies because this spell does cover a wide area, and if you're in an enclosed space like inside a cave, this spell will not hit any enemies because the meteorites fall from the sky. But this skill is the strongest sorcerer spell that can easily one-shot certain bosses. Now, one thing to note is that this spell also works on golems, even though it does fire damage. An alternate weapon skill you can use is the sorcerer's other meister skill, Maelstrom. And this spell will conjure a whirlwind that deals massive damage to enemies that get caught in its path. This meister skill has a very long channeling time, and it is unaffected by the core skill, quick spell. Now, this skill has a slightly shorter channeling time than the other meister skill, Meteoron, but this spell does slightly less damage. Now, this spell does physical damage, so this spell will work on golems. Now, personally, I prefer using Meteoron due to its slightly higher damage and visual effect, but you can switch these two meister spells around depending on your playstyle because they are very similar in damage and channeling time. Okay, so next for the core skills. And the core skills for the sorcerer are very useful. So the first core skill is Bursting Bolt. And with this skill, you can charge your basic attack, Magic Bolt, and then unleash it to an enemy for a powerful burst damage that will also explode for more damage after some time. Now, I typically don't use this core skill because casting a spell or just spamming your basic attack with the spell, Augural Flare, will do a lot more damage. And the next core skill is Quick Spell. And this skill will greatly hasten the channeling time on your spells, except for the sorcerer meister skills, but in return it will consume stamina. This is a very strong core skill, allowing you to quickly cast your spells, and I use this core skill all the time to quickly unleash my spells. And the last core skill is Levitate, and this skill will make the caster be able to float in the air. This skill is really good to reach difficult places, and this skill will also help you escape and reposition in some situations if you get surrounded by enemies. Okay, so next for the augments. Now for the augments, I did focus more on damage compared to survivability, so I can easily melt bosses. Now, because you will be mostly in the back line, taking defensive augments are not really needed, but there are times where you can get ambushed. So the first augment I'm using is Asperity from the Sorcerer, and this will increase the likelihood of inflicting debilitations with your attacks. This augment is really good for your spells that inflict status effects to be applied more often. The next augment I'm using is Constancy from the Sorcerer, and this will increase your knockdown resistance. Now, even though you will be in the back line, this augment will help if you get ambushed. And the next augment I'm using is Catalysis from the Sorcerer, and this augment will increase the damage dealt when exploiting a hostile's target's elemental weakness, and this is effective for boosting your damage against specific enemies. And the next augment I'm using is Sagacity from the Sorcerer, and this will increase your magic, thereby boosting your overall damage output. And the next augment I'm using is Lethality from the Archer, and this will increase the damage dealt when striking a target's vital, making this really strong against bosses. And the last augment I'm using is Subtlety from the Thief, and this will decrease the likelihood of being targeted by enemies. This is really useful for avoiding attacks and ensuring your spells aren't interrupted. Okay, so next for the equipment. Now, I am in New Game Plus, and all the best equipment is from the Dragon Forge, except for the cloaks and rings. So all my equipment is from the Dragon Forge, but the cloaks and rings. And in order to trade items from the Dragon Forge, you will need Wormlife Crystals. And Wormlife Crystals are obtained by taking down dragons. So for the weapon, I'm using the Dragon's Wit, and this is the strongest staff in the game. For the head armor, I'm using the Deadly Nightshade, which is the best helmet for the Sorcerer. And I'm also using the Prowler Kerchief, which will make you more difficult to detect from enemies. For the body armor, I'm using the Silhouette of Sorcery. And for the leg armor, I'm using the Runic Gaiters. Now for the cloak, I'm using the Champion's Mantle. And the cloak is purely for style and not required. Ideally, you don't want to wear a cloak because it does increase your weight, which can make you run slower. But since I'm in New Game Plus, I upgraded my gear with enhancement that reduces your weight, so weight is not an issue. Next for the rings. Now the first ring I'm using is the Ring of Percipience, which will increase your magic for more damage. And the next ring I'm using is the Ring of Recitation, which will greatly reduce the time when channeling a spell, but in return it will reduce your maximum health. And this ring is really useful for the Sorcerer because the channeling time can be quite long for some spells, and since you'll be in the backline more often, reducing your maximum health shouldn't be a big issue. Okay, so next, where to upgrade your gear. Now, the best place to upgrade your weapon will be at the Sacred Arbor. You get the Elven Enhancement. The Elven Enhancement will greatly increase your magic, but has little effect on strength, and this enhancement will slightly reduce its weight. And as for the armor, I personally like to enhance my armor in Verm. The Verm Enhancement will boost all your stats, and it will slightly reduce its weight. And since you're in the backline, it's better to have lower weight, so you move faster to dodge enemy attacks and reposition. And in the backline, you shouldn't be getting attacked often. Okay, so next, if you want to check out my stats. Now, I am level 66 and have all the best equipment. The Sorcerer wields massive power, capable of dealing devastating damage that can outright obliterate certain bosses and swiftly destroy dragons. However, the Sorcerer can be a bit vulnerable in some situations due to the lack of defensive options or escape skills, but that's where you rely on your pawns to help draw aggro. So ideally, you want a fighter in your party. Also, if you're hit while channeling a spell, your spell will be interrupted. And next, I'm going to show you some gameplay destroying this dragon. Okay, so thanks for checking out one of the best, strongest sorcerer builds in Dragon's Dogma 2. The sorcerer is a very powerful vocation that can easily one-shot certain bosses and melt dragons. I've shared the best skills, setup, and gear upgrades for this build. Hope this helps and more videos to come, so stay tuned. And don't forget to give your pawns a high five.